Hi everyone, this is Sheila Rabin. My presentation is, what is IIIF?
The International Image Interoperability Framework, or IIIF, has been a buzzword in the digital library community. But what is it and what does it mean? IIIF is best described as a community that develops shared application programming interfaces, or APIs, implements them in software, and exposes interoperable digital image content on the web. IIIF exists because scholars and researchers increasingly rely on digital image repositories for access to images of important artifacts like manuscripts, newspapers, maps, and other fragile, rare, and heavily studied cultural materials. Libraries, archives, and museums across the globe have been increasingly making their collection materials available to the public digitally, but online assets have essentially been locked into repository-based silos with incompatible systems and varying user interfaces that place a burden on hosting institutions and limitations on functionality for end users. Digital collection websites have been developed essentially in isolation, and significant resources are needed to migrate and overhaul these snowflake systems as time goes on. Working independently, many institutions have found digital image repositories challenging to maintain, with constantly evolving user needs and ever-changing technology systems as digital content is migrated from one bespoke application to another. Working together in response to these challenges, institutions and individuals from across the cultural heritage community developed the IIIF specifications to provide a standard practice for making digital images available online, allowing for the transfer and sharing of image pixels, metadata, and annotations across repositories and systems. Adoption of the IIIF specifications can provide end users with the ability to compare images from across multiple repositories and interact with them through deep zoom and pan image manipulation, including size, quality, rotation, the ability to tag and annotate, search within annotations, and easily share work with others. Several image servers and clients that support IIIF already exist, allowing institutions to easily mix and match technologies and maintain their repositories while avoiding costly system overhauls, migrations, and redesigns. The IIIF community encompasses a large and growing group of interested and active individuals and organizations dedicated to leading and sustaining the IIIF. As a community-driven initiative, IIIF thrives on active discussion, input, and feedback from a wide array of diverse perspectives, from libraries, museums, cultural heritage institutions, software firms, and other organizations working with digital images and audiovisual materials. Several interest-based community groups have formed within the community to address particular facets or applications of IIIF, including manuscripts, newspapers, software, and museums. There are also groups working on technical specifications for discovery of IIIF resources and extending IIIF to apply to AV materials as well. Any organization or individual interested in adopting IIIF, developing software to support it, or giving feedback on the effort is welcome to get involved. The IIIF community currently encompasses over 100 organizations, and the IIIF consortium is comprised of 41 institutions currently that provide sustainability and steering for the initiative. Adoption of the IIIF specifications provides benefits for both repositories and end users. Repositories can avoid vendor lock-in, complicated migrations, and expensive system overhauls by utilizing interoperable IIIF technologies. IIIF provides the ability to separate image delivery user interfaces from back-end data stores, allowing repositories the ability to update image servers and databases without changing front-end delivery, or vice versa, avoiding the need to re-architect the entire stack. With an active and growing community of organizations developing and supporting IIIF-compatible technologies, there are plenty of software options to choose from. A rich ecosystem of interoperable software, including many high-quality open-source options, keeps licensing and operational costs low and predictable over time. Repositories can use any IIIF-compatible software for viewing, annotating, comparing, and manipulating images, regardless of the backend server, and swap parts of the stack at any time, or run multiple components in parallel at once. The IIIF specifications are based on existing web standards, using RESTful API construction, JSON-LD, and existing web patterns, including the W3C web annotation standard, which simplifies processes for data migration and sharing. Repositories can publish images once and reuse often simply by changing HTTP request parameters for an image's size, a region of an image, rotation, quality, and format. IIIF is currently comprised of four specifications known as the IIIF Image API, the Presentation API, Content Search API, and Authentication API, all based on the IIIF design patterns. The IIIF Image API provides instructions for the transfer of image pixels between various servers and clients across the web. The Image API provides the very basics of digital image interoperability, and there are different levels of compliance. The Image API allows for the manipulation of image pixels for changing size, rotation, quality, format, and highlighting regions of interest within an image. Clients can either request a full or partial image or information about an image using a standard image request URI syntax. Information about an image is returned via a info.json file using JSON-LD. The IIIF Presentation API takes interoperability further to allow for the transfer and sharing of information about an image, including descriptive metadata, structural metadata, rights information, related resources, and annotations. This way, users have access to more complete information to describe the images they're interacting with, especially title, table of contents, and sequencing information, if applicable, and any additional annotations related to the image. The IIIF Presentation API is based on the Shared Canvas data model, in which images and related information are essentially painted onto an abstract space known as a canvas via W3C web annotations and annotation lists. Typically, a canvas consists of one page or one view of an object, although multiple canvases can be painted onto a single canvas, which is especially helpful for multispectral imaging or images missing content that can be reunified with the same image from a different resource. The IIIF Presentation API leverages linked data, existing web architecture, and the Shared Canvas data model to describe information about an object as represented in a JSON-LD document, referred to as a IIIF manifest. Within the Shared Canvas data model, a manifest represents a physical object, like a book or a newspaper. Multiple manifests comprise a collection, and objects containing multiple pages or parts are comprised of sequences of canvases, each containing specific content represented as annotations within the JSON-LD manifest. The IIIF Image and Presentation APIs thus work together to present to the user a digital surrogate of a physical object, with the ability to manipulate, annotate, and otherwise more fully explore cultural heritage objects on the web. The IIIF community is currently working on extending the IIIF Presentation API to include AV materials, which will entail adding a time dimension to the Shared Canvas data model. The IIIF Content Search API allows for searching text within the annotation layer of a single IIIF resource, such as a manifest or collection. For example, searching a keyword within an issue or collection of issues of a newspaper. The IIIF Authentication API provides the option for repositories to make restricted content available through IIIF. According to the IIIF Auth spec, open access to content is desirable, but internal policies, legal regulations, business models, and other constraints can require users to authenticate and be authorized to interact with some resources. The authentication process could range from a simple restriction by IP address or a click-through agreement to a multi-factor scheme with a secure identity provider. The IIIF Newspapers Community Group meets virtually once a month to share, discuss, and determine best practices for IIIF as it applies to digitized newspapers. Chaired by Karen Esland of Penn State University Libraries and Glenn Robson of the National Library of Wales, the group has been working to leverage and document the technical details and benefits of IIIF for digital newspaper collections, with considerations for the content aspects unique to newspapers such as columns of text, use of OCR, publication date, and non-contiguous sections. Anyone with an interest in digital newspapers is welcome to join the IIIF newspaper group calls and discussions. The newspapers group has mapped general newspaper metadata to the shared canvas data model used by IIIF. Adoption of IIIF for digital newspapers is led by institutions including the National Library of Wales, North Carolina State University Libraries, and the Bavarian State Library. The National Library of Wales has made all of their newspapers available via the IIIF Image Presentation and Content Search APIs using the Universal Viewer, as shown here. North Carolina State University Libraries have also made many of their newspapers available via the Image Presentation and Content Search APIs. The Bavarian State Library recently announced the release of roughly 350 newspapers now available through IIIF. And the Maryland Institute of Technology and the Humanities has recently been investigating incorporating the use of Mirador and the Mirador Viewer for digital newspapers. Penn State is currently working with the University of Nebraska, the University of Oregon, and others to launch the Open Online Newspaper Initiative, or Open ONI, which supports the IIIF Image API and uses the Rays Image Server and OpenSea Dragon client. Open ONI is a fork of the Library of Congress's Chronium software used for the Chronicling America historic newspaper site. For awardees from the U.S. National Digital Newspaper Program, NDNP, it's now easier than ever to make digital newspaper images available via IIIF. Ed Summers at the Maryland Institute for Technology and Humanities developed a shim to convert NDNP Metz XML metadata into IIIF JSON-LD. For information about the NDNP shim and other helpful resources, please see the newspapers section of the awesome IIIF list. And if you want to learn more about IIIF in general or more detailed aspects, please feel free to join our email list. It's IIIFDiscuss@googlegroups.com. There's also an excellent intro to IIIF article written by Tom Crane from Digirati, a UK software firm that has been on the forefront of IIIF adoption. Thank you for your time, and I look forward to any questions.